Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see how to use Microsoft Word 2016 quickly and easily. Leave us feedback to improve our future video guides. Microsoft Word is a software used to manage text in order to create documents, advertisements, flyers, and so on. When you open it, a startup window appears. Here, you can choose a ready template to use. If you want to start from scratch, just click on Blank Document. A Word document can be seen as a group of sheets of paper where you type in. In the Home section on top, choose the font style, size, properties, and color. These properties will be applied on the new words you type. To change properties on existing text, just select it and use the Home section or the dialog box that appears above. For more advanced text properties, just right-click and go to Font. You can select the text precisely holding your click and dragging, or holding Shift down and using your left and right arrow keys. If you double-click, you will select an entire word instead. If you want to select one or more text lines, just click on the extreme left and drag up or down when the pointer becomes a mirrored arrow. You can cut, copy, and paste selected text right-clicking on it. The piece of text cut or copied is pasted starting from where the pointer is. You can use copy and paste to import inside Word text coming from other sources. If you have a mistake, remember to use Undo in the top left corner, or simply press Ctrl and Z. If you ever need to zoom, just hold Ctrl down and use your mouse wheel. You may notice also wavy underlined text. This happens when you make mistakes in grammar, spelling, or punctuation, according to the language dictionary chosen at the very bottom. In some cases, Word corrects the mistake automatically using the autocorrect tool. When it doesn't, this line appears under the text. In this case, if you right-click on it, you can choose some suggestions to correct the mistake. Mind that those lines won't be printed in your final document. You can hide those anyway, right-clicking and going to Ignore All. While creating a text document, you must set the page layout, which is the way the text must spread and be distributed. A text document is composed by different text lines, collected inside text paragraphs. In short, you finish a paragraph every time you create a new line with Enter key. You can check each text paragraph enabling the paragraph mark in the Home section. Each of these paragraphs can be managed in a complete independent way. In the Home section above, under Paragraph, you can adjust the paragraph alignment. This acts on the text paragraph selected or where your pointer is. You can also adjust the line spacing inside the paragraph, add any fill or any border. To adjust the indentation, which is the extra uniform space added from the left to the paragraph respect to the rest of the text document, just use Decrease and Increase Indent. You can adjust indent and line spacing also under Layout section. Very important for the layout is also the ruler, on top and on the extreme left of your document. If you don't see it, just go to View and tick on Ruler. Each ruler is composed by two main parts, dark ones, also called margins, that indicate the safe distance you want to keep between the sheet edges and the inner text content, and white parts that contain your document. You can set the extension of each by dragging the margin resizers. Word will make sure that all that you are going to type inside will be contained within the white ruler. The ruler well interacts with each text paragraph written independently. For simple text layouts, the ruler shows two white markers. The right one sets where the text paragraph must spread through a new line. The left marker is composed by two parts. The upper one sets the indent of the paragraph, so where the first line of the paragraph must start. The downer one moves the wall left marker, setting the distance between the extreme left edges of the document and the paragraph interested itself. Plus, if you hold the shift down, you can move the downer part on its own, moving all the paragraph lines except the first one. If you drag any ruler marker while holding Alt down, you will be able to check the distances in your default measurement unit. You don't have any marker for the vertical ruler, since its margins set when the text starts and when ends inside your page. The default page layout spreads text over all the page, single column, and uses a default page with a standard size. Under Layout section on top, you can adjust all margins, change the page sheet orientation, and also set the size of the sheet of paper to be used between different standards. In Columns, you can apply text columns on paragraphs selected by adding new dark margins inside the ruler that you can edit and adjust as you like. So, when you copy a column fully, you start typing in the next column from top. Your document may also need to make indices and lists. Inside Home, under the Paragraph section, you can make lists. You can choose between the bulleted list, a numbered list, or a multi-level list. The bulleted list indicates each line with a symbol. The numbered one orders each line through a number or a letter incrementing. The multi-level list has different levels or indents instead. You can change symbols and formats going to the down black arrow next to the list's icons. In case you have a document divided in parts and chapters, you may need to use headers and footers. These are text elements that are included in the margins of the ruler. If you double-click inside each area, the header and footer tools appears on top, and you will start typing inside a header if you are at the top of the page, or the footer if you are at the bottom. Click outside to apply. The header and the footer content appears with some transparency, but mind that this transparency is not rendered in the final document, but it is just an effect used to separate the text document from the header footer content. This kind of text can be set like any other text using the Home section. Mind that the headers and the footers get repeated when you create a new following page. Those headers and footers are also linked. If you change one in one page, you will change all the others in other pages. You can use the footer, for example, to add numbers to each page, going to Page Number in Design section. To create independent headers and footers, just open the linked ones, indicated as same as previous. If you click on Link to Previous under Design on top, the open header or footer will become independent from any page, and you can edit it as you like. You can also insert quick references. If you go to References on top, and to insert footnote, a footnote will be added where your pointer is, and automatically its reference below, between the text document and the footer more below. Word is able to insert extra items and objects to make your document more professional. Just open Insert section on top. With Table, you can add a table. You can move it through the small icon in the top left corner and set its sides by dragging the rows and the columns contours. You can also add new rows and columns clicking on the plus sign that appears when you hover on the borders. On top, under Design, select the template and any style and color. Under Layout, all table options regarding space and distribution. In Insert, use Pictures to browse and insert a picture inside your document. You can modify and correct the aspect of the pictures through the Format section on top. It is very important to fix the relationship between the picture and the text. In the top right corner, you can set the picture layout options. By default, the picture is in line with text, so you can treat it as you do with a text paragraph. If you choose any text wrapping, the picture won't be treated as text, but becomes an object you can move and fix completely freely. For example, you can move it simply by dragging it elsewhere, scale it dragging its white nodes, or rotate it through the central top icon. You can also add description to such pictures. Just go to References and then to Insert Caption. Through Insert, under Shapes, you can also add simple objects like polygons or arrows. Those can be moved and modified as seen for the pictures. If you need to add special symbols or math equations instead, just go to Symbol and Equation inside Symbols. When your document is made, just save it. Go to File and then to Save As. Word documents are saved as .docx, and this format lets you open again your document in order to edit it anytime. If you need to export it in order to print it, just save it as .pdf. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our full Office 2016 guides for more.